this is intense. Intense is a good word. Sometimes it's very hot, and then you have like going down, going up, going down, a lot of muddy. You need to be prepared.
It's exhausting. It's hot, it's sweaty, we have the helmets, we have the face mask, and then we jump into these caves with the beautiful structures inside, incredible bats, and we start exploring and taking all the information that we need to protect them.
How's it feel down there, Jen?
Very hot, very humid, a lot of sweat.
We are at the entrance of St. Clair Cave in Jamaica. We have at least 2 million bats using this one cave, 10 different species, including the critically endangered Jamaican funnel bats. So 250 individuals of this one bat only found here in the world. Unfortunately though, there's a huge feral cat population here. So every night they're running the gauntlets through all these cats just going after them. Every time we go into this cave, we see parts of bats on the floor. All around us right now are cat latrines. It's just an awful, awful sight. But the fence is a long-term solution. We can prevent the cats from getting in, but they can still self-extract. The fence kind of goes up like this and it has a lip. So we're not trapping them in here. They can just go up, over, out, but then they just can't get back in. Working with the community has been the breakthrough on this. St. Clair Cave is a stone's throw away from Polyground. Anything we do, we cannot do without the community support. They are the custodians of this amazing site, and they've been instrumental in installing the predator-proof fence. They have rallied in bringing the big steel pipes, big bags of cement, sand, water, you name it, and that's what's enabled us to actually get this done, because it has been a real community partnership.
There was nobody here who thought well of a bat. We never thought a bat was anything more than an evil spirit, a vampire. When John from Bat Conservation International came, he began opening to us about how important the St. Clair Cave really is. And then he told us how important the bats are to the community, how much insect they eat at night, that they also help with pollination. I was blown away. I sat there and did a 180 degree before John was done speaking. I tell you, I saw in the group that started coming, I saw people who really had our interest at heart. The kids, they're so happy, and that's what we use as a marker to know when we get good people. If our children run up to you and embrace you, we know you're a good person, you're good people, and that's what we've seen.
The BCI team has done wonders for our community. People are looking forward to them each time they come down. They taught me that there are more than one, you know, more than umpteen a number of species, and some that they thought were extinct, and they're here in Jamaica in a cave that we didn't even care about. It's just an amazing thing to see a place that you've known all your life, a world has just opened up. I mean, that gives a lot of pride. BCI is going to have its part in Polyground, you know, for generations.
So within the Endangered Species Interventions team, we work on specific interventions to save bats from extinction. In a lot of cases like this, it's a really small thing that needs to be done, like building a predator-proof fence, buying a small parcel of land, and it has such an outsized impact on a species, 10 species at St. Clair, 2 million bats there, a few thousand here. Today we're at Stony Hill Cave, which is the last known maternity roost for the Jamaican flower bat. This bat was thought to be extinct for almost 20 years before it was rediscovered, only in this one cave. This is a busy area for development. Every time I come here and drive up the road, there's a new house going up somewhere.
These are critically endangered species, and when we lose this cave, we lose the species. All the species have an intrinsic value. I understand that it's very important for us to see the economic value of bats, but they have their own value per se, and we need to protect them.
Most of the people, they don't know bats, so they don't like bats. From the moment that you start to learn, you can appreciate more. And then when they discover about the pollination, about the seed dispersal, about the pest controls, they can relate more.
As the cities and the different urban settings are growing, animals don't have where to go. animals start to becoming part of that new environment.
If any more trees get lost from around here, we're getting extremely close to seeing the extinction of this species. I mean, this is the last known maternity roost. This is where all the mums come to give birth, raise their pups, feed them until they're old enough to fly. Thanks to our membership, we were able to generate the money needed to buy the first parcel of land. That just saved the cave entrance from any form of development. And once we do own the land, it enables us to put measures in like the predator-proof fence. That's what excites me, knowing that this bat's going to be protected. It's a beautiful species, and anything we can do to save a species, it should just be done.
We take things for granted. The more you get educated about wildlife and their purpose, then you start to appreciate it. Future generation of Jamaicans will understand also what bats is all about, especially Jamaican flower bats.
We have shown how we can save a species from going extinct. Humans have a moral obligation to protect these species. I mean, we're the ones changing the landscape. I feel we are the ones that should be looking after these species. And again, it's natural capital. If we look after biodiversity, biodiversity is going to look after us. If we protect the ecosystem, not just the cave, but the wider ecosystem around us that the bats are using as their foraging areas, it's going to benefit all of us and save bat species from going extinct as well.
My hope for the future of bats and people in this place, I would love for us to find that balance between bats and people, to where the bats serve us, but we also need to serve the bats. We recognize that nature is what we have to offer. And so we're now looking at, wow, the time is now come. And we're going to make every use of this time. We're going to strike the iron while it is hot, and we're going to so strike as to make it hotter still.
Girl, I got some money to chase. May not have time to waste. So make me look out for my eye. Drop the top, make me look at the stars. Or we could chill for the seaside. Face God, know that he